feels like a test that I fail so depressed when I can't seem to get out.
Hey, 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 thank you for joining for another review. My name is Jacine and I'm so happy to see you here. Today I'm coming to you from my kitchen because, as I teased, if you follow me on my Instagram or on Facebook, then you will see that I asked whether or not you guys wanted to see me do a review of this dish drainer, this over the sink dish drainer that I recently purchased. You know, it's a convenient item for me, and I thought, hey, I ordered this and I think maybe people might be interested in, you know, finding out what my experience was like getting something like this for my kitchen. But before we get into the review, I just want to ask you, if you are not already a subscriber to my channel, please go ahead and hit that subscribe button. It's the red one down below. It's free for you to subscribe and it helps me to build my following. So I would really appreciate it if you become a member of the J Review family. Also, if you like videos like these, you know, hit that like button. Give me a comment down below to let me know what you think about these videos. Hit that bell notification too if you want to know whenever I upload new videos. Alright, so let's get into the review of this brand new over the sink dish drainer. So for me, I kind of like cute things. My friends say that I'm bougie and whatever, and I like expensive things and whatnot. To me, expensive is relative, right? But I've had this sink or a dish drainer on my counter that it was kind of ratty and tatty looking. I'll put a picture in so that you can see what it was looking like. And I'm like, I wanted something cute and something that would be aesthetically pleasing in my kitchen. And my friend Stacy also had a similar one to this. So I asked her, okay, sweetie, where did you get this? I need to get myself one because, one, I want to be able to save space, and I also want something that looks cute in my kitchen. So I decided to go ahead and order this. Now for me, I ordered this drainer on Amazon and I'm gonna be linking it down below. I'll give you multiple options. I'm actually located in Jamaica for those of you who don't already know. So when you order on Amazon, you have to send it to a shipper who will then ship the item to you from whichever, usually it's an address in the US, and then they ship it from the US to you here in Jamaica. You can also order directly from Amazon because they do international shipping, but I actually use more than one shipping companies here in Jamaica, and I'll talk about that later in this video. So please do stay to the end to find out more about how I ship my items from the US or from here in Jamaica, and I'm located in Kingston, Jamaica. All right, guys, so I ordered this on Amazon. I paid roughly $42 for this, which would be the equivalent of around $6,500 Jamaican dollars. I didn't think that was too prohibitive a cost for what you are getting, but then you also have to add the cost of shipping it from the US to Jamaica to that expense. So that is the price that I paid for the item. So let's go ahead and just take a look at, you know, how this fits into my life, how it looks in my kitchen. So this is what it looks like. This is my demo pretty much. So it comes with this top shelf on here. It has more that it just fits into the groove. And this is also here. So you have the grooves here for your dishes. You see, I already have some dishes here. These are actually the trays from my air fryer. Let me know if you want me to do a review of my air fryer experience. I can do that for you as well. Then you have a little section here for your utensils, I have a spatula and a fork and spoon here. You can stick your knives here. There's another nifty little section here for things that you might not want to get lost. And then over here, you have the section where you can put your sponges, etc. There's another little section here where you can hang things. So I have like my tongs here. And I'm guessing that this section would be for your cutting board or your cutting board or any other items. I guess you could just put it here like this. and that's that little nifty area there. Then you also have some space here where you can put like your dish soap and other items, your hand soap, etc. There are also some hooks. I think I should have put the hooks to the front, but for some reason I have them hanging at the back here. And what you can do with that, let me see if I can do a demo, is hang things like your utensils, your ladle, or in this case I'm using my tongs, and you just have it, you're hanging it right there. So for me, this is nice and convenient to have, and it looks cute in my kitchen. So that's pretty much my demo of this over the sink dish drainer. In terms of putting it together, it was pretty simple. I am not the most, I don't even know how you describe it. I'm not the best in terms of putting things together with my hands and doing electronics, etc. And for me, it took me like maybe about 20 minutes to put it together. It was quite simple. And you will see footage of me putting it together in this video. And also, it was just, I mean, it's just general common sense, which, I mean, common sense isn't that common, but it wasn't too hard for me to put together. So, all in all, that's kind of the demo for this item. Now, let's talk about the shipping. I shipped this particular item along with another thing that I was shipping with Access Point Couriers here in Jamaica. I had a bit of a challenge because if you guys aren't aware, there is this thing where in Jamaica where customs charges you a tax or a fee if you purchase items over a certain threshold, and that threshold is $50. Now the cost of this item was over $50 before the discount, and they asked for my invoice. And so because they asked for my invoice and they saw that the price was over $50 initially, they still charged me the fee, or the customs fee. And I was not amused because I deliberately looked for an item that was less than $50 so that I wouldn't have to pay the customs fee. So for me, I ended up having to pay the cost of the item, the fee to ship, and the customs fee. And I ended up paying something like $4,000 for my shipping, and that would be roughly, let's say, $30. So in total, I ended up paying something like $70 or so for this purchase. In terms of the pros and cons of this, for me, I really like it. It saves space. I know I have more space on my counter now. This over here is where I had my dish drainer. You see now I have all different other things that I can put here because it has saved me this space. In terms of whether or other pros for this item, I think it's really cute. It's aesthetically pleasing in my kitchen. And I also think it is affordable, especially there are actually dish drainers like this on Amazon that are listed for under $40. I think $39.99. I'll link it down below for you in case you're interested in ordering it for yourself. And so you have to take into consideration, if you're ordering it to Jamaica, make sure that the item actually costs less than $50 unless you're prepared to pay that customs fee. In terms of cons for this item, you will have to put it together yourself or get somebody you know to put it together. So if you are not good at that kind of thing, then you might want to rethink this. But for me, as I said to you before, it was pretty easy and simple to put together. In terms of the space that you get, as you can see, it's not a whole lot of space. So if you're washing a lot of pots and pans, or you have a big event or whatever, this might not be ideal for you. But I don't really want to have a whole set of things packed up in my dish drainer, so I am happy with this one. So guys, that's it for my review on this dish drainer over the sink. I think it's pretty cute. I'm really happy with it. I love it. I love to see it. I just look at it in my kitchen and I'm like, oh, this is so cute. I mean, I know that might be weird to you, but these are the kinds of things that I like in my home. So thank you for staying to the end of this video. If you enjoyed this review, please give me a like on this video. Comment down below if you have an over the sink drainer like this in your home, or if you intend to get one. Hit that bell notification if you want to know whenever I upload new videos. Once again, thank you. Thank you so much for watching, and I look forward to seeing you in my next video. Cheers. Bye.